Why did you leave me? I can't tell you how much I loved you. Hi. Sorry, I thought you were someone else. How can I help you?
I'm looking for Miss Claire Summers.
That's me.
My name is Robert Daniels. I'm an attorney with Moyer in Greenfield in Washington, D.C. I have news relating to your father. May I come in?
You must have the wrong person. My father passed away when I was 7 years old.
I'm afraid it's not the case. He passed away last week. I'm here to deliver items according to his will.
That's impossible.
You recognize this man?
It's me, silly. Open up.
Have you decided to be an active member of society and join me at the rally today? Claire, what's wrong? You look like you've seen a ghost.
Kinda. My dad. He passed away last week.
Oh my God. Claire. I'm so sorry. I thought he
died when I was little. Yeah, me too.
This lawyer came and gave me this vase, some keys to a storage unit in DC, and my inheritance. I don't want any of it. I think I was better off thinking he had died a long time ago. Don't you want to at least see what he left you? What difference does it make? Claire, I understand you're in pain. You can't change what happened, but you could figure out why it happened. I don't know. Mel, I'm not really in the mood to hang out today. It's cool. Don't worry about it. Call me if you need anything. Or I could stay. No. It's okay. I'll be fine.
Claire, I think you're doing the right thing going to DC. Just stay with my friend Tina. She lives right in the city.
I'm gonna ask you to look away. But it hurts to pray. The life I have isn't what I'd seen. The sky's not blue and the field's not green.
Oh. so much for letting me stay with you. I just got to DC. I'll be there in like 15 minutes. Okay, bye.
Why did you leave me? I cried myself to sleep for years, hoping for a miracle, hoping to see you just one last time, praying until I ran out of prayers and ran out of faith. I just want to know why. Part of me hates you. How could you? All along, all this time, you weren't dead? But now you are. And I can't tell you how much I missed you. I can't tell you how much I loved you.
your father.
What?
Claire, I'm Jim. I've known you since you were a little girl. I've known your father for 30 years.
Uncle Jimmy?
You shouldn't have that out. Come with me. Your father worked really hard to keep that safe.
I don't know what you or my father were into, but I want no part of it. I just came here to put his ashes away. I did it, so here, you can have it. You can take it.
No. He must have given it to you for a reason. Your father always thought things through. You should keep it safely. You know, you're just like him. Just driven by curiosity. But he didn't even want you to be involved with this. He wanted to protect you.
Protect me from what?
Your father was a Freemason, Claire. An international secret organization dating back to the late 17th century.
Right. That's a hell of an excuse to abandon his family. Is that what he asked you to tell me?
Not just any Mason, Claire. A Grand Master Mason, responsible for guarding a deadly secret.
Don't all Masons have deadly secrets?
What people don't know is there's several rogue societies, all practicing some form of Masonry. Of course, not all are sanctioned by Masons, similar to Catholics and Protestants. Claire, sit down. Sit here. Come on, seriously. I think your father may have been murdered for the secret he was guarding.
What?
There's a rumor that he took the secret, broke it into three different pieces, and then hid it in three different places. The first revealed the identity. Second location. And finally, Claire, the truth. I shouldn't even be telling you this. I promised him I wouldn't let anything happen to you. Here. He used to carry this around with him. He said the day you were born was the happiest day of his life. He suddenly had purpose. He said you gave him clarity. Hence the name, Claire. You should go home. Take care of yourself. Don't get involved in this business, right? Don't. Nobody.
We go back a long way, Jim. I can tell when you're lying.
Look, I've told you, she's nobody.
Playing both sides is a very dangerous game. We have far too many pieces on the chessboard. to make any bad moves.
Do we have what we need? We need to set things in motion, right?
Patience, Jim. Meet me here tomorrow. I'll have what you need. But I'm telling you, we can't afford any more missteps.
The key lies at the center of freedom's reflection and democracy's greed.
Hello.
How many Freemasons signed the Constitution?
Hello to you too.
Is Tina being a good host? She giving you a hard time?
Yeah, she's great, but how many, Mel?
Okay.
13. It was 13. Benjamin Franklin, George Washington, Thomas Jefferson.
Wait a minute, Mel. It says here that Jefferson never signed the Constitution. He was in France during that time.
But he signed it, and then he was like a big part of the debates forming the Constitution.
There are
are several clues, and they all point to the number 33, except the Constitution.
Clues? Claire, are you okay?
It's time to party! Is that Melissa?
Yeah.
Tell that heifer I said what's up.
Thanks, Tina, but I can't go out tonight.
Suit yourself.
Don't let Melissa drag you down to Nerdville.
Anyways, I'm out.
I'm sorry. She's so clueless.
I don't know, Melissa.
I think your friend is smarter than you think.
Yes. I've taken care of it. It won't be a problem.
I'm gonna ask you to look away. I love my hands, but it hurts to pray. The life I have isn't what I'd seen. The sky's not blue and the it's not green. Wait for me. Wait for me. Wait for me. Wait for me.
The key lies at the center of freedom's reflection and democracy's green.
Thank you.
Dad, what are you trying to tell me?
Your father always said you were an intelligent girl.
You know the truth, don't you?
No. I was too smart to ask that question. It's too dangerous to know the whole truth.
But the Masons, the Constitution, Cornerstones, Washington, now Jefferson. I don't understand. My father knew a secret about the Constitution, didn't he?
Didn't I tell you to go home and not get involved in all of this?
Look, I came here to get to know my father. But I think there's a lot more that he wanted me to know. How does Jefferson fit into all this? Tell me, what's this big secret?
It's just the biggest secret in American history. The truth that we've been operating under a false government since the birth of our nation. Listen. In the 1840s, a man stumbled upon the original writings of Thomas Jefferson. The Constitution that Jefferson was drafting stated limited terms of Congress, no death penalty, Native American lands had to be paid for, no standing military. And he proposed to abolish the biggest crime ever committed by the United States, slavery.
My God, it would have changed history.
Slavery was big business. Native American land was like gold. There was no way these men were gonna let that happen.
The people you warned me about want to keep it a secret. Why? It doesn't matter. Nobody will care. It's not gonna change anything.
Have you seen this country? Globally, we're falling behind in everything. Economically, we're in ruins. Our military's overextended. The confidence of the American people's been shaken to its core. They've been passing this philosophy down through generations. Your father and the organization that he worked for, they wanted to expose them, but there were spies everywhere. There are people, dangerous people, that will go to any means to make sure the truth's never known. But there are also men at the highest level that want these documents found. They want them found to spark the people, to spark the revolution that we need, or the greatest country that you and I have ever known. We'll be no more. Okay. Be careful. Take it. Lewis. 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 What's up, man? Wake up, Lewis.
morning, 7:45 p.m. to the Baltimore Camden Yard Station. All aboard, please. For your safety and security, Amtrak kindly requests that you keep your carry-on bag at your side at all times while at the station. Bags of an unattended will be confiscated. All carry-on bags must have identification tags on them at all times. If you need identification tags, your bag will be with you.
How may I help you?
How did you get my information, my name?
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
I found an article. My dad died under a different name. You couldn't have known I was his daughter. I know the truth. I know who you are.
Did Jim talk to you about your father?
I don't know who you're talking about.
The Jim that you don't know is dead. We're the only ones know about you, Claire. And be both in our best interest to keep it that way.
I want to continue my father's work.
And why would we let you do that?
For the same reason you contacted me in the first place.
I'm the only one that can decipher his work.
And you know, the best way
to keep a secret is behind another secret.
Well, you truly are your father's daughter.
Yeah, I've inherited a lot from him. You know where to contact me.
Life I have isn't what I seem. The sky's not blue and the field's not green.
Smart girl. She figured it out.